taking the shot. What the?
Too slow, cowboy.
I'm on vacation right now. I guess you could say this is my idea of getting in touch with nature. You might also say it's time I found myself a new hobby. At this moment, I got two thoughts bouncing around the inside of my skull like ping pong balls. One, next year I'm going to Hawaii. And two, what the heck am I doing hunting a man-killing grizzly in the middle of a blizzard? I reckon this might be my last chance to explain.
They call it the Order of Orion. It's an exclusive club for elite big game hunters from all over the globe. Every year, the Order hosts a competition. I got the call for this year's hunt, and I couldn't say no.
often contain bonus challenges that test your marksmanship and observation skills. Feel free to use your camera to snap photos of rare species or other interesting sights you might come across in the field. Now follow the navigation marker to find your final trophy.
I once hunted in the Montana Badlands, not far from here. And as Salem's big game hunter, my father taught me the art and science of the hunter's craft in these same woods. I had the home field advantage, and I can't pick a better spot to kick off this year's world tour.
Gentlemen, if I could have a moment of your attention. A few minutes ago, Mr. Friedkin shot a record-setting trophy buck from a range of 450 yards in a brilliant display of marksmanship. Bravo, Mr. Friedkin. Your reputation is clearly well-deserved. Looks like the rest of you have some catching up to do. Target, try using your call to lure your trophy into the open.
The tournament ran like a who's who of elite big game hunters from all over the world. Olivier Matisse, gold medal marksman from the wilds of Quebec. Roger Freakin, a legendary game warden from Johannesburg. And of course, the high self-esteemed Trey Cassidy, the one comedian who started that reality show about big game hunting. Despite the prize money and all, we got along pretty well.
Mr. Hathcock, this is Sharp.
What's on your mind, son?
I've got fresh mountain lion tracks here.
I wasn't aware we had any cougars in this area.
You do now, and this is one big cat, sir. 6.5 feet from head to tail, maybe 200 pounds. Looks like he's got a wounded right front paw.
I see.
That's the part that worries me. An injury like that can make a mountain lion aggressive and extremely dangerous. I figure we need to put the word out.
Good work, John. I'll make a couple of calls and get right back to you. Now, my colleagues and I have discussed the matter, and we have decided to temporarily suspend the normal tournament rules. We want every hunter on that cat's trail. And that makes the kill will receive a substantial number of bonus points. What the heck was that, John? That wounded cat poses a serious threat. Get after him and finish the job.
I'm on it.
March, John! Outstanding! acting work, John. We watched the whole thing play out on live TV. You have not lost a step, son. No, sir. The rest of you men can go pack it in for the day. Get some rest tonight. We got an early morning flight tomorrow and another long day of hunting ahead.
Jordan Hathcock always reminded me of a character from an adventure novel, a Texas soilman with a lifelong passion for big game hunting. He even put out the $250,000 prize money out of his own pocket and said it was a small price to pay to hunt alongside the best big game hunters on the history of the planet.
You can hold your breath to slow down time for precise shooting. The bullet needs time to travel a long distance. Remember to always lead a moving target. Don't forget to use the zoom on your scope.
We just walked onto the set of a spaghetti western.
I reckon I must be the good. Matisse over there's gotta be the bad. What's that make you, Sharp?
I'm gonna be the one with the fistful of dollars after I school you guys and collect that prize money.
Cathcock calls this desert bandit country. It's a wonder why old Pancho Villa built his hideout in these canyons. In the summer, temperatures reach 120 degrees in the shade. Here, it's a good place to hunt, but I wouldn't want to live here.
Afternoon, gentlemen. Thought you all might like to know that Monsieur Matisse had stolen the point lead in some rather impressive long-range shooting.
It was only a matter of time. An amateur may get lucky once or twice, but in the end, the superior marksman will rise to the top.
Yeah, well, kudos, Frenchie. Couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
The dust storms south of the Rio Grande can peel a man's skin like a potato. I found shelter in a deep arroyo, waiting for the storm to pass. As soon the air was clear, the hunt began in earnest.
Mr. Hathcock, you there?
What can I do for you, John?
I found some boot prints, sir. Looks like somebody's been hiking through my shooting zone. Recent, too.
Probably just some local ranchero out rounding up strays. I wouldn't pay any mind to it.
Copy that. Shooting into my zone. Matisse, that was my shot.
Gentlemen, please. Now, I admire your competitive spirit. However, I must ask you to refrain from unsportsmanlike behavior. This brings to a close the Mexican stage of our competition. That's two hunts down and three to go. So far, you boys are putting on one heck of a show. We're wheels up at 0600 tomorrow morning. Don't miss the flight, or you'll be riding the bus back to our side of the border.
Our next destination turned out to be Hathcock's own private game ranch. 10,000 acres of prime East Texas wetlands. These wetlands are ideal for bow hunting. Out here, stealth and patience trump long-range marksmanship.
Welcome to East Texas, gentlemen. These wetlands are perfect country for bow hunting. Out here, you'll
need to use stealth. Be aware of your surroundings and get in close to make the kill. If you haven't used a bow in a while, now'd be a good time to shake the rust off. Shoot a few arrows on the range to warm up before you move on to the first hunt.
Hey, thanks again, guys, for helping me out of that jam with the Mexican police. I'll be sure to thank y'all in my speech after I win that trophy.
It's gonna cost you more than that to keep these pictures off the internet, Cassidy.
Pictures? What pictures? Friedkin, what's he talking about? He's joking, right?
Out here, a hunter keeps his eyes open and his finger on the trigger. The imported European boars were a nasty breed. Some of them weighed in over at least 400 pounds, but it's the homegrown alligators that pose the biggest threat. We quickly learn to stay well clear of these murky waters. We were being watched from the moment we set foot on those marshes. I knew Hathcock and his boys had a great view of the action, but none of us, hunters or spectators, knew the dark turn that were ahead.
Trophies here. map. Can you see where it's going?
We lost video contact 15 minutes ago, but now his GPS is out too. Probably just another technical glitch.
I don't like it. Someone should check on him. What's Friedkin's last known location?
Let's see, about 300 yards northwest of your current position.
This hunt is over, Mr. Hathcock. At least till we know Friedkin's okay. On the western ridge of the river gorge. Looks like Roger took a nasty fall while descending.
That doesn't sound good.
Mr. Hathcock, he's gonna need some medical attention. Pronto.
Copy that, John. Medevac chopper is en route to your position. ETA, 15 minutes.
Is he gonna make it, John?
We're not out of the woods yet.
The surgeons were able to save Friedkin's life, but he lost his left leg. After some soul searching, the rest of us moved down to Namibia to continue the competition. The sweltering African savannas were a welcome change from the swamps of Hathcock's ranch.
Watch your backs out there, gentlemen. You've all hunted Africa before, so I don't need to tell you how dangerous this place can be for a man on foot. Stay sharp. Bag your trophies and get back here in one piece.
Roger that, Mr. H. Playtime's over. From here on out, I'm in it to win it.
It is a shame your friend had to have an accident to start taking this seriously.
Well, I'm dead serious now, Matisse, so you best bring your A-game out there.
In all of my travels, I've never come across country as wild or as beautiful as these Namibian grasslands. And it's a wonder how the first European hunters came all this way, looking out over a primeval landscape that hasn't been changed for millions of years. Not since the dinosaurs has nature got this majestic. Those windswept fields of tall grass concealed even greater danger than the murky waters of Hathcock's Ranch. We weren't the only master hunters prowling these plains, and it wasn't always clear who was hunting who.
Heads up, people. I've got lion tracks crossing east-west through my zone.
They're not uncommon this time of year. Usually, just a couple of young males passing through on their way to the Delta.
Not this time. This is a hunting pride. Could be trouble.
No animal should trouble a prepared hunter. Out here, we are the apex predators.
Top of the food chain, baby. Couldn't have said it better myself.
All right. Just don't do anything stupid.
Why do I get the feeling that last comment was directed at me?
What's up, Trey?
I think we got a bit of a situation here. I shot a prime trophy bull out here, but looks like someone else has taken an interest in my kill.
Lions?
They're in the grass. I can hear them creeping around. I think I'm surrounded. I think they can hear me.
If you can hear them, they can hear you and smell you.
Listen. Listen to me, Trey. You need to move away from that carcass. Slowly. Get out of that grass.
Too late!
Hathcock!
This can't be happening! No, not again! How could this... I was so careful. I tried to see every opportunity and every possible scenario.
Matisse!
I'm on your way. I'll meet you there.
I got Cassidy's pack and rifle here. I must have just missed him. Tracks all over the place. Multiple blood trails.
We spent days searching for Cassidy's body in Africa, but we never did find him. It was down to me and Matisse now, and we come to the end of the line. Kodiak Island, the most wild and unforgiving scrap of North America, seems fitting to end our journey like nothing felt like the end of the world.
Gentlemen, welcome to Kodiak Island. There is no country on this planet as harsh and unforgiving as the wilderness that surrounds you now. We've all heard the news stories about Bloody Ben, the infamous bear that has terrorized the inhabitants of this island over the past year. Many hunters have tried to bring down old Ben, but I believe you men have what it will take to succeed where others have failed. We will hunt these woods for 3 days while keeping a vigilant watch for any sign of that bear. The point total is nearly dead even. Between both remaining hunters, I can safely say that the man who kills Bloody Ben will win the tournament. Good luck, gentlemen, and good hunting.
Matisse and Hathcock spent the night swapping campfire stories about Bloody Ben, the man-eating grizzly that had terrorized the island for a decade. I knew now that Bloody Ben's the reason we came to Kodiak, the reason for this entire competition.
Your attention, please, gentlemen. We received a warning of an Arctic storm descending rapidly toward Kodiak Island. In the interest of the hunter's safety, we have decided to end the hunt early and return to the mainland. Weather permitting, we can try again in a few days.
No, absolutely not. We did not come this far to give up and go home because of a little bad weather. I say we stay and finish what we started. Sharp, are you with me?
I agree with Matisse. I'd rather stay and see this through to the end.
I admire your grit, gentlemen. You are a credit to your countries and to the hunter's noble tradition. The final stages of our hunt will proceed as planned.
As the blizzard hit, I could sense Bloody Ben stirring somewhere out there in the storm. We were closing in on old Ben's lair. One way or another, this hunt would soon be over. A new legend will be born, and another will be laid to rest.
Gentlemen, the moment we have been waiting for has arrived. Bloody Ben was spotted no more than 10 minutes ago near Whalehead Lake, just north of your current location. Normal tournament rules are hereby suspended. You are both clear to stalk and kill that bear by any means necessary.
I'm glad it came down to us, Sharp. From the beginning, I knew you were my only real competition.
Yeah, well, you're not so bad yourself, Matisse. But you could use some work on your people skills.
It has been an honor to hunt with you.
We'll see if you still feel that way after I win this thing.
Not a chance. That bear is mine. Situation. The question is,
what happens next. In about 2 seconds, I'll either be headed home with a legendary story to tell my grandkids, or they'll be carrying me out in a doggy bag. Moment of truth. What's it gonna be?
You don't want it?
I don't think it'll fit in my trailer.